Hello everybody, in my ongoing search for interesting books that go a bit outside the ordinary, this time I'm having a closer look at an interesting manga, being a Japanese style comic book. Well, what do we talk about? The series is called Pluto. It will be 8 volumes in total, and we have at this moment that I make this video, there are 4 volumes. Why is this interesting? Because, well, manga, if you are not so familiar with it, maybe you've seen already these booklets. What's already particular, if you're not familiar with it, you have to begin at the back and really read from right to left. Which, this is really the Japanese style. Some manga are mirrored, but many are not. Now, you get quickly used to it. Now, what is special about it? Well, first and for all, it is made by the artist Urasawa, Naoki Urasawa, who is one of the top manga artists working today. His two previous series are really, benchmarks. First one, Monster, is a 20-something series about a serial killer in Germany and a Japanese doctor trying to stop him and find him and the like. And then 20th Century Boys, a more recent series about a big conspiracy. Actually, all these books, and also the new one, they have indeed an element of a big conspiracy that must be stopped. It's a topic that Urasawa is well interested in. I must also say, so Pluto will be 8 books, and I think that is actually better than the previous two series, which I said these are benchmarks, the other two masterpieces. Well, this one is as well, and the 8 books, well, it's still 1600 pages of comics, will make certain that there are not too many dead moments. His longer series had some a bit too many detours, etc., which detract a bit from the pace. Anyway, what is remarkable here, this is not just a new comic book series. Meanwhile, for your enjoyment, I show you a few other sleeves. It's always the characters there of the books. Actually, it is a reworking of a classic manga by, you see the name here, Tezuka. Now, Tezuka is the grandfather of manga in Japan. He's a bit like what in Europe we have Hergé, creator of Tintin. In America, you have Stan Lee, creator of Spider-Man, or Eisner from Creator of the Spirit, or even Little Nemo in Slumberland. So somebody classic who had a lot of influence. Now, Tezuka made many, many comics, and several ones are truly excellent, truly well-written stories, but always with a very charming, simple drawing style. Tezuka made simple stories, and one of his most popular series is actually about this little boy that you see here, which is here the Urasawa modern rendering. It's quite European actually, his drawing style, except for the telltale manga eyes and the way he does a nose. It's a very Japanese comic book way of drawing that. Now, this boy is called Atom, and Atom is actually a child robot, also known as Astro Boy, of which there will soon be a new animated movie. So a classic Astro Boy manga comics, that is what Tezuka became really popular with in the 1950s and 60s, I believe. So one of the story arcs is about a conspiracy that the 7 most advanced robots in the world are being killed one by one by a mysterious, probably a robot. There is something really wrong there. Now, what Urasawa did actually, he reinvented his story and put a lot of modern interesting details in it. So, what do we have? Well, it's actually a murder mystery. But here you see one of the main characters is a robot inspector called Gesicht, which means actually in Germany face. Notice, by the way, it's quite filmic, how it goes from a white image to the zoom in and then to the window. That's what you can do with 200 pages per book. You can have a lot of room for cinematic build-ups. Few more samples of the faces and so on. So well drawn, correctly drawn, very competent, and it's a kind of art that that you forget after a while. I mean, you're really sucked into the story. So what I wanted to say is, where is it? What makes it modern, actually, and interesting? So indeed, we are still talking about robots being murdered. You have several influences here. Think about Asimov with his laws of robotics. A robot shall not kill. That comes in here. Definitely Blade Runner, with robots a bit seen as second-rate citizens. That's also there. And also, more than a hint towards the recent war in Iraq, because there was. We're talking also in moments about an inspector group that have to find robots of mass destruction. So it is actually, for many ages, but it's not really for children. It's quite complex, the story. Like I say, a good, well-built murder mystery. Here you see, I hope that the camera focuses reasonably well, an image of the city Düsseldorf in the future. It resembles a bit, indeed, Blade Runner, but then without the rain, or definitely Akira. Maybe you've seen that classic anime movie. So, beautiful, I would say. Another picture from the fourth book. Something ominous going to happen. An appearance, strange, scary creature. And really built like a movie, with various chapters that are intersecting, that are happening in parallel. You see again the drawing, the drawings, clean drawings, quite European in style, I would say. A lot of dialogue, very filmic. There's no old-style text in between the images. It's really, you can almost immediately make this into a TV script or a movie script. So actually, it's 20th Century Boys is being made in a three-part movie, which actually I've seen a part of the first one. It's not so good, I must say. I think here there is really room to make an intelligent science fiction movie, because it's really intelligent. It's not banal kind of robot story where, well, you can imagine. Eh? We're not talking here about Transformers. It's not about big toy robots, no. It's about robots who come really to live amongst humans. And actually are evolving themselves, and which causes tensions, but also sometimes friendship between the robots and the man. So in this context, it sometimes seems a bit like Blade Runner. And I would say, well, if you are interested in well-written science fiction, and perhaps you're not even used to reading graphic novels, well, I cannot imagine somebody being disappointed with Pluto. Even if you know that you don't like manga because of the big eyes, the teenage schoolgirls and so on, well, this is not like that. This is a very different style and aimed at a more mature audience. So it's quite universal, I would say, the appeal of this. And also it poses interesting questions about consciousness and what it is to be human as well. Because the difference between the human and the robot is not so evident. So it's a subtle story, intelligent and well made. I really recommend Pluto, like I say, already four, at the moment of writing, there are four volumes. Coming in a few weeks, there will be the fifth, and half a year from now, hopefully, the series should be completely published in English. In French, for those who are French-speaking, I read somewhere that's also being translated, but I don't know exactly when it will appear. It's published by Viz Media, in actually somewhat better quality than most manga. You see, it has dust covers, a bit, well, it's a paperback, but really nicely produced. Bon, with this, This was Pluto, a short review. I hope you find it interesting, and as always, feel free to give bluntly honest feedback.